The demand for lithium-ion batteries is growing at an exponential rate ever since their commercial introduction in 1991. As a society, our desire to be mobile created smaller and more powerful devices which demand the same of the lithium-ion batteries powering them. Unfortunately, in the pursuit, they can be more dangerous. Stories of exploding lithium-ion batteries inside of hoverboards, cell phones, e-cigarettes, and laptops are making mainstream headlines. The demand for lithium-ion batteries is still increasing. 2.1 billion units were sold in 2015. That number will nearly double, with an estimated more than 4 billion units sold in 2024, according to Transparency Market Research. As users and recyclers of batteries, we must guard ourselves with the best safety practices while using lithium-ion cells and devices and properly disposing of them through recycling when we are done. Let's first discuss how and why lithium-ion batteries catch on fire.
Lithium-ion batteries float for several reasons. Sometimes it's due to design flaws, and sometimes it's through misuse. Like charging your phone or laptop on a couch or bed, leaving it in your car on a hot day, or even overcharging it. That heat can cause the electrolyte inside the battery to raise its vapor pressure, causing the battery to bloat. These bloated cells can explode in two ways, one by being breached, or the other by the continued physical expansion causing the cell to burst, usually violently. This is called thermal runaway, and it's hard to stop once it starts. In simple terms, the batteries are going to explode, and they're going to catch on fire. These fires can reach temperatures of 1600 degrees Fahrenheit. We are seeing a dramatic increase in the number of bloated batteries we receive for recycling. Therefore, on occasion, we may have an incident solely based on the number of batteries we receive for recycling. Even by following the US DOT regulations for safe storage and transport, everyone handling lithium and lithium-ion batteries can succumb to a fire. The good news is there are precautions we can and must take in order to guard ourselves against having a fire with these damaged and defective batteries.
The U.S. Department of Transportation devotes a special section of lithium battery regulations to handling damaged and defective batteries. Each of them must be placed in a container by themselves. At Battery Solutions, we offer a U.S. DOT-compliant kit to safely transport damaged lithium cells. There are two sizes. One kit holds 9 batteries, and the other holds 1 battery. Each kit includes an anti-static plastic bag, a smaller cardboard box, a larger cardboard box, an outer UN-approved flame retardant box, required labels already attached to the packaging, a pre-cut strip of box closure tape. Now, let's properly package a damaged lithium-ion battery for safe handling and transport. Here is a bloated lithium-ion cell phone battery. This is absolutely a battery that requires this kit. First, place the battery in the plastic bag and close the bag. Place the bagged battery in the small cardboard box. Place the small cardboard box into the larger cardboard box. Place the box in the flame retardant overpack shipping box. Close with the provided tape. The prepaid return shipping and the US DOT compliant labels are already on the box, so it is ready to ship. Now that we've covered how to safely transport damaged, defective, or recalled lithium or lithium-ion batteries, let's talk about safety taping non-damaged and non-defective lithium primary and lithium-ion batteries. There are many types of lithium batteries, but the two most common are the lithium-ion rechargeable batteries and lithium metal, also known as lithium primary, which are not rechargeable. Per U.S. Department of Transportation regulations, all lithium primary and lithium-ion batteries with easily accessible terminals must be taped for safe storage and transport. The proper safety technique is to place a piece of clear tape on the terminals. This prevents the battery from creating a closed circuit, which causes an evolution of heat and a fire hazard. Some lithium-ion batteries by design cannot short and do not need to be taped. But when in doubt, err on the side of caution and put clear tape on the terminals. Place the batteries in one of our iRecycle kits that already include the proper labeling. If you are using your own cardboard boxes or drums, you must use the proper labeling for transport of lithium-containing batteries. This includes a Class 9 placard and an identifying lithium metals, lithium-ion label affixed to the container on two opposing sides. Examples shown are just a sample of the designs available. There is a severe danger associated with damaged, defective, and recalled lithium batteries, and improperly packaging regular lithium and lithium-ion batteries. Now that you know, protect yourself and your environment by following the proper guidelines. For more information about lithium battery safety, please visit www.batterysolutions.com/resources/lithium-ion-safety.